think of home brew, you might remember the dodgy beer that dads used to make to save money. Oh. But these days, it's all about craft brewed drinks like ginger beer and apple cider. And some are even non-alcoholic.
Sam, oh, that's Mealing, it. I'm out of here.
Sam Mealing from the Hop and Grain Brew Store in Sydney joins us now to show us how easy it is to make it at home on our own.
Hey.
Brew it at home.
Hi, Sam.
Very good. Thank you.
This all looks very, very technical, yeah. Like a science experiment.
It's pretty straightforward. Most of this stuff is things that you'd find in your kitchen.
I wouldn't find that in my kitchen. What is it?
There we have got a few different pieces that are sort of brewing specific. So these are our fermenters. They're going to be fermenting there.
There was Granny's kitchen in Louisville, Kentucky, maybe. Yeah.
So you've got your fermenting jars.
Yep.
And then what's this?
So
exactly?
That's called an airlock. So basically, when it's fermenting, the yeast produces a little bit of carbon dioxide. It all bubbles up. And what that does is it allows the gas to release so the bottle doesn't blow up, build up pressure, but it stops anything nasty getting in, bacteria contaminating it, that sort of thing. So that's
we use one of these on Jono? I love you, Jono. It's always looked, a friend of mine once did homebrew, and even the best ones he did were horrible. It always looked like so much trouble. That's, like, you know, you go to the supermarket and think, oh yeah, there's a home brewing kit, that'll be nice in about 3 months' time.
Yep. I mean, to be honest, you can make stuff much quicker than that, and in terms of, like, everyone's got a story of someone who's done a bad job of it, had some bad beers or some bad ginger beer. To be honest, things have changed quite a lot in the last couple of years in terms of the products that are available and the knowledge that's out there. It's not hard to do it yourself at home.
All right,
it's
so not what are we doing here?
We've got a ginger beer, so we've got basically some water on the boil. Now I've got some ginger and graters for the both of you. So if you can start grating that for me.
Okay.
And do we do it coarse or the coarse?
Yeah, the coarse side is fine.
Do we need to take the skin off?
Nope, skin on is fine.
Okay.
So I've basically got my fermenter that I showed you before. I've got some cleaning product in there. That basically just kills off any bacteria that's in there.
Okay.
So basically we're just going to tip out the extra cleaning product. We're not going to need that.
How much water have we got boiling in there?
So we've got about 4 litres, 5 litres, something like that. We're trying to make a 4.5 litre batch, which these guys are 5 litre if you fill them right to the very top, but we don't want to fill them all the way. They usually come to about here, just the shoulder of the bottle.
4.5 litres. How much ginger are we talking? Just the whole.
This is, I think we've got 280 grams or thereabouts to work with today. So.
And we're also going to do an apple cider.
We're
going to
do a cider. We're going to start off with the ginger beer because we'll need to let that boil for a little bit so we can get that all in the pot, get it boiling, get it working away, and then we can kick off on the cider.
Okay, so is that enough there?
That's good, that's looking good.
Okay.
You don't need every last scrap of it. And if you want to tip that into the pot for me.
I do want to do that.
That would be great.
There we go.
Beautiful.
There you go.
Ginger smells gorgeous, doesn't it?
It is beautiful.
I've actually got a bit of a cold.
A little bit more heat onto it.
Yeah. Very nice.
All right. So the other thing that we're going to add to the pot there is we're going to add some cinnamon.
Yes.
And some citrus zest. So I've got a lemon.
Zesty.
Would you like to zest
that for me?
Sure,
I'll zest that lemon.
You've got just a peeler there. It's probably the easiest way of doing it.
Okay.
You can just do it with the box grater.
Actually, it's hard to get it out once you've zested.
Yeah, that's right. And because we're going to boil it all up,
it's
all going to extract anyway, so that's fine. And I've got some cinnamon as well, so always nice to add a little extra flavour to it.
Now, we might have to cheat a little bit, given it's the magic of television and the fact that we only have about 3 minutes left on the segment. So you'd boil this, you'd boil it up, take it to the boil once you put all these lovely things in it.
That's the zest.
Yep.
Great.
Beautiful.
Very nice, nice zesting.
Oh, that smells good.
It does.
And what about the alcohol? How do you put the alcohol
in? So basically, when it comes to brewing, the more sugar you put in there, the yeast ferments that and turns that into alcohol.
Right.
So we're making a non-alcoholic version of the ginger beer today, which basically we're not adding any additional sugar at this point.
Okay.
It's all right, we're going to make a traditional cider.
Great, okay.
So we've got some what we call dry malt extract, which is basically sugar that's made from barley malt, and we've got just some regular old raw sugar. And
so
that's
that
what we would
well?
Put in if you were making the sort of traditional ginger beer. But we're going to make a alcohol-free version. This is great. You can do it at home with the kids or what have you.
Fantastic.
Nice and easy.
Yeah, that's what I want.
Once
more time with the kids.
So once that's boiled, how long would you boil that for?
So just about 10 minutes. That kills off any bacteria that's in there.
Yes.
And then we need to allow that to cool all the way down before we stick it in our fermenter and add the yeast.
And it ferments.
Okay.
And it ferments
about
for about a week.
And what about the cider?
So cider, we'll get kicked off on that one. So first thing I'm going to do is we're going to make a little bit of tea, which is, I know sounds strange, but what you tend to find, because we're using store-bought juice, your really traditional old English ciders and that sort of thing, they use really tannic, astringent, kind of bitter apples.
Yeah.
Right. And you find that that's very hard to get at the grocery store sort of thing.
Right.
So we make a little bit of a tea, And we might use a couple of tea bags, actually. Sure. Mm-hmm. And that will extract a little bit of the tannins from the tea. So that'll just make it a little bit more complex.
Can I put another one in?
Go for it.
Hey.
All right, so we've got our clean, sanitised fermenter here. Now, when I say it's been sanitised, you can see that it's got this kind of foamy stuff in there.
Yep.
Don't worry about that. It's not like dishwashing detergent. It's not going to taste, taste funny or anything like that. So I've got some cleaning product there, another sanitising product.
Fantastic.
I'm just going to clean off the funnel that we're going to use.
If you don't sanitise it properly, what can happen? It just becomes a bit of
it goes off.
A petri
so
dish.
It becomes, it can become
vinegary. Like me on a Saturday
night. Yeah.
Okay, so can we pop this in?
Let it steep for a little bit longer. Let's get the juice in there now.
By longer, do you mean less than a minute?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Do you want to throw that pear juice in for
yes,
me?
Yes, I do.
Yeah.
My Croatian,
don't spill
my
it.
Croatian uncle makes rakia at home. And it is, it's sort of like a Croatian grappa. It is like rocket fuel.
Yeah.
It
Whoa.
Is
probably,
yeah.
probably
awful.
Shouldn't say that on TV because it is actually illegal to distill your own spirits at home. But
anyway, he died. He's not doing it anymore.
Yeah, he's
cider, ginger beer, beer. That's all fine. Spirits, it's a little bit of a grey area there.
Okay, right. So we put in the pear juice,
put
the
in
apple
some pear juice.
Juice,
some apple juice. How are we going with that?
The tea?
That's looking nice
right.
and dark now. Let's throw that in.
All right.
And
now we're gonna let this brew, I think, and then come back for a bit of a.
That's bang on. That's where it needs to be.
Beautiful.
Perfect. We have been playing around with a bit of home brew this morning. Sam Milling is here, and you've made some apple cider and some ginger beer, Sam.
Yep, so we've got some tasters of some stuff that we've prepared earlier. So
it smells
fantastic.
Great.
You poor Joe. So this is the ginger beer here.
Yep.
Pass it on. There we
it's
go.
Got some cider.
It's got alcohol in it, so I have to sit this one out. It's alcohol, I can't.
Can I have a ginger beer?
But you can just
hold it.
What would you like, Sam?
I'll have some cider.
And you can
I'll have
in.
Both.
All right, hang on.
That's me.
Shalom.
Cheers.
What do we think?
Oh, that's actually pretty good.
You yeah. like?
I might just take this
oh,
home.
Oh, that's I like that.
Ooh. Nice.
Yummy.
Here's the sinuses.
Now,
very
you
nice.
Can go to Sam's website if you want some more information on how to brew your own. Thank you so much, Sam.